Do you want to ride faster or just with more control? I want to show you one simple dirt bike throttle control technique to make you do just that. I want to show you what it is, why it's important to giving you more control and make you faster, and then how to simply put it to use, how to practice it. And if you want to learn all the basic techniques to riding with confidence and control, I want to give you a free guide to do that. It's in the link is in the description below. So what this technique is, it's the roll-on technique. So why it's so important is because it's giving you more traction. A lot of riders think that if you just stab the throttle, it's really cool, it sounds fast, it feels fast, and you're roosting a lot, but what you're doing is the rear tire is just spinning, and if it's just spinning, it's spitting up dirt, and you're not actually accelerating. So if you have less traction, you have less control, less speed, and that's a bad combination for riding with control. And it also puts more wear and tear on your bike. More RPMs in your engine wears it out just a little bit faster, as well as the tire. If you like changing tires, which I hate doing, a faster bike doesn't make you faster if you're not putting the power to the ground. That's why I like riding a slow trail bike in the woods, because with proper technique and some momentum, I can keep up with 450s on like an old XR200, which has like a third the power. It's all about putting the power to the ground. So how do you put this to actual use? How do you get better with your traction and accelerating? Well, you find a straight spot and or a corner, and you put it in second or third gear, and then you roll on the throttle. So you're at just above idle speed, and you just slowly roll on the throttle, get a feel for what it's doing and accelerating, and then all the way to full throttle till the throttle is locked. And a lot of people think they're going wide open, but there's still a little bit more. So roll it on until it's full locked, and then let the bike wind out, and once it stops accelerating, you don't want to hit the rev limiter, or at least for very long. I don't like hitting the rev limiter. So you do that, and then what you do is the next time you roll it on a little bit quicker, and this makes a big difference when you're coming out of a corner. You can tell when this tire, the rear tire starts spinning out. So if you roll on the throttle faster and faster coming out of a slippery corner, you'll start to feel the rear end slide out, and that's when you know when you're giving it too much gas too soon, so you need to roll it on smoother. So if you like this tip and you want to go more in depth to become a better, safer rider in less time, I want to give you the basic techniques guide. It's a simple step-by-step, just bullet points with some description on how to improve your technique to become a better rider. You can get that at motocrosshideout.com/free-lessons. It's in the link in the description below. So now I want to hear from you. Are you one of those guys that loves to roost it? Do you agree with me? Is this a good technique? Will this make you, do you think this will make you better? Will you accelerate faster? Let me know in the comments below. This is Kelly from Motocross Hideout. Learn more, ride more.